What it do, y'all? It's J-Rox, and you're watching Disney Channel. I'm just kidding. So I don't have an intro because I'm not a YouTuber, but y'all have been begging me to make YouTube videos for I don't know how long. So I'm going to do a Q&A today. So yeah, y'all better like it. I'm going to be real mad. So the first question that I got these from my Instagram story, by the way. I had y'all submit some. So let's start. So I'm Anthony Zamora says, how old are you? Well, Anthony Zamora, let me tell you, I'm 18 years old. My birthday is October 4th, so I'm going to be 19 next month. And I share a birthday month with two girls, which is SPM and Eminem. Y'all already know. Next question. So Yesenia, I don't know how to say her name, said, how did you meet MC Magic? So y'all are going to think it's a little bit crazy, but I hadn't listened to MC Magic in years. I grew up listening to MC Magic, but I hadn't listened to him in years, right? So I randomly felt like listening to MC Magic, and that's when I was listening to Princesa, and I'm like, dang, this song goes hard. Like, and I was like, why isn't there more music like this now? Like, why? And so I was like, I'm gonna make a song like this. And so, like, you know MC Magic's style? I don't know how to explain it, it's just his style. And so I told my dad, I was like, Dad, I need to write a song like this. And as you guys know, I don't speak Spanish because I was never taught. Don't come at me, they never taught me, okay? So I told my dad I want to write a Spanish song like MC Magic style. And he's like, you're crazy, that doesn't even make sense, you don't know Spanish. And he was being a hater, basically. So I was like, whatever. So then I wrote some Spanish chords, and I was like, I forced him to help me write it. It was like 10 o'clock at night, and I wrote Mi Amor, which is on the album. You guys could go listen to it if you have never heard it before. But I wrote that song for him, and my dad's like, dang, this song is so good. He thought it was so good that he decided to contact MC Magic, and of course they did not respond to us. He gets so many emails, text messages, everything. He did not want to respond, you feel me? I mean, not that he didn't want to respond, but he doesn't have time to respond, you know what I mean? And that same night, someone had asked me on my story, who are your top artists that you would like to collab with? And MC Magic was my number one. And literally the next day, he was going live on Instagram with fans, and I requested and he chose me, and I got up so quick out of my bed. I always say it like that. So I jumped out of my bed and I grabbed my guitar and I was like, can I please sing for you? And he goes, go ahead. And so the first thing that did I sang his song. So I sang that for him and he liked it. So I was like, can I sing an original song? And I took the opportunity to sing Mi Amor for him, the one that I had written with my dad. And so I sang it to him and he liked it so much that he was like, Jay, do you want to be on my next album? And I was like, you're crazy. Like, maybe I'll put a clip right here. Maybe I don't know. I'm new to this YouTube stuff, okay? So anyways, I just thought he was crazy because he is. Yeah, so that's how I met MC Magic, through an Instagram live. And when I met him in person, we vibed so good, and him with my parents too, like so good that he decided that he wanted to sign me. And that's when we started working on the Princesa album. There you go. Next question is from Jackie Moi. She asks, why did you start making music? So as y'all know, in high school, I did not have a lot of friends, and everyone thought I was weird. I always say they're right. However, because of that, because of the lack of friends and blah, blah, I turned to music because music was my best friend. And I've always loved music ever since I was a little girl. But going into high school, it's a lot different, you know, the social life and whatever the hell bullshit. And oops, excuse my language. But, you know, and so music, I feel like it was my only friend. And music was always there for me when no one else was. So I used to love writing music. I was obsessed with music. I always had my earphones on. Ask anyone that went to my high school. I didn't talk to nobody. People that would try to talk to me, I would unintentionally ignore them because I always had my music on. It was like music, music, music. I would always get in trouble when we would be leaving the house because I would forget my earphones and I had to run back inside and they would be waiting for me, taking forever. But music is just a huge part of my life. It always has been. And that's why I wanted to make it, because it makes me feel at peace. It's my language. It's my drug. It's my drug, you feel me? Next question. When did you get your braces off? Can we see a before and after? By the way, you're freaking pretty. Thank you. I bet you are too. Mirian Serrat, I don't know how to say your name. And when did I get them off? I got them off like literally like what, a week ago or 2 weeks ago? The dentist said, it's only gonna take 6 months. Girl, it was a year and a half. Here's my teeth now though, they're so pretty. I'll bite you with them. I'll put a before picture right here. Ugly, right? And I'll put an after picture right here. Ooh, girl, you are popping. That's right. Get it, girl. Okay, next question. My favorite album, the Slim Shady LP, is one of my favorite albums of all time. Of course, I like other artists, but that's just such a good album. It's just, it's fire. Next question. CCXNRVD says, do you have any hidden talents or hobbies? Yes, I do. One time I wanted to learn German because I found out that I was 1% German, so I was like, might as well, like, you can get in touch with my roots, you feel me? So I learned the German alphabet. So y'all want to hear? A, B, C, D, G, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Bang. And I know that that's right because I met this German girl and she told me that I was right. She said everything was accurate. Next question. What is something you have always wanted in this world? Something that I've always wanted in this world to date Eminem. I'm just kidding. Something that I've always wanted in this world to make other people happy. Because I know what it feels like to constantly be let down by people that you thought were there for you. I just want to be able to make other people happy just by, you know, like with my music or maybe by being myself, if that encourages them or inspires them in any way, shape, or form. I just want to make people happy because I know what it feels like to not be happy and it sucks. That's the truth. I just want to make people happy. You know, I'm a people person. I love humans. I have no hatred in my body, even if I wanted to. I'm incapable. I just love people and I just want to make everybody happy. Next question. Ariana Perez says, do you fuck with chickens? Homie, I'm a vegan. I don't fuck with chickens. You can see it to my face, but I still won't listen. That's from Two Chicanas. That's my verse. So if y'all have never heard that song, you better go listen to it right now. Next question. Uni something these nuts. I like your name just because it says these nuts in it. But do you have a name for your fandom? Yes, we do. We came up with this a long time ago. It's rock stars. I'll type it out because a lot of people spell it wrong. It's ROXXTARS. I'm gonna type it though so y'all can see we're the rock stars. You feel me? Next question. Jax L13 says, if you could pick your top three people to do a collab with, who would it be with? You already know I'm gonna say Eminem. Definitely X. And I know he passed, but still, that would be my dream. Don't put me on the spot like that. I don't know. Next question. NSHTX.Ellie asks, what is one thing that impacted your life emotionally? I got two things. When X passed away, because remember how I told you all that music, I feel like it was my only friend in high school. And that's what got me through all my days. That's the only reason I liked going to school, was to listen to music. I hated high school. I hated it. I would never want to go back. So when X passed away, it was like, it sucks. You know, it's like, you already don't have friends. You already have people that they just don't understand you. I was always friends with teachers and adults and my parents' friends and never people that were my age. And so when X died, it's like, dang, like, you don't have friends. You don't really connect with the people that are your age. And then your favorite artist dies. Like, that sucks. You know what I mean? And it really did take an emotional toll on me because I was like, that it just sucks. I would look forward to seeing his stories, his little vlogs. I loved him. I got to see him live his life. And so I shouldn't say I loved him because I still love him. But so when that happened, that's what inspired me to start writing music, because I wanted to in some way continue his legacy. The second thing that I mentioned was when my tata passed away, which was on the 4th of July in 2020. And that really affected me because I've never dealt with like such a personal death at such a young age. And when my dad passed, it just sucked because he always believed in me so much, and he never got to see any of my big shows. He never got to listen to his song, I Belong to You. I wrote that for my tata, and you know, it sucks. And it inspired me though to get more in touch with my Chicano roots and culture and Mexican culture and everything, because my tata was all about that. Next question. What made you get the name J-Rock? Well, growing up, my dad used to think I was gonna be a boxer, so he would always call me J-Rock. That was my boxing name, all right? That's why we have boxing in the intro to the music video to Chicana. Growing up, I used to box, and he always thought that that's what my career path was gonna be, but I didn't love it. And so he would call me J-Rock. And then when I found out that music was my passion, that's when we added the triple X at the end of my name, because of X, as you can see, like, I even got a tattoo for him, triple X. It was my way of paying homage to X, and also because there's already a rapper named J-Rock, so I didn't want to have, like, you know, I didn't want to seem like I was biting his name. We used J-Rocks and it worked out for the best. Next question. Tattoos. I just saw one of my tattoos. I only have two, guys. I only have two tattoos, and it's this one, which is the Pachuco cross. I got this in honor of my tata. My tata used to have this tattoo in the exact same spot. I got this on February 19th, which was his birthday, which was also the day that we released my album and also the day we released the I Belong To You music video. So I got it in celebration of his birthday. Went to this after party at Rob the Original's house, and he tatted me, my dad, and little Rob, and we all got tattoos in celebration. So this is what I got, just the Pachuco cross in honor of my tata. This one, I got this on X's 3-year death anniversary, and I just got the triple X inside of my fingers. It hurt so bad, but it was worth it, so whatever. Those are all my tattoos. I'm not a big tattoo person because they hurt a lot more than I imagined. Next question. Do you have a crush? Oh yeah, definitely. Eminem and Central C, you already know. He's my most recent crush though. Next question. This is from That's Mondo, this fool. He said, when did you get your first kiss? So to be honest, I don't think I even had any type of memory when I had my first kiss. I think it was when I was born though. I don't know who kissed me first. Like, was it my nana? I thought that my mom or my dad. I don't know who it was, but I'm guessing that's when. So way back in 2002. Next question is from 661.itzel. She says, opinions on people telling you that your voice doesn't match the style of music you sing. Well, all I gotta say is ika kafu. You know what does match? The streams to my bank account. I'm just kidding. If I listen to people that hated on me, I would not be making this YouTube video right now. I would be doing nothing with my life. So, next question. Violet Lena, I don't know how to say it. She says, go to Starbucks order. Yeah, every time I post my Starbucks, everyone wants to know what it is. And my order is literally in my highlights, but it's okay. I'll say it again. I'm going to say it here because I need you guys to never forget this. This is what I call the J-Rocks drink. It is a venti iced matcha green tea latte with oat milk and 4 pumps of vanilla. There you go. I'm gonna put it on the screen because I know y'all are gonna forget. So screenshot it, okay? Whenever you order it at Starbucks, tag me in it so I can see it. We're trying to get Starbucks to name it the J-Rocks drink, okay? Next question. Baby Doll Diamond says, why did you become vegan? So I became vegan when I was like 13 years old because I used to feel bad for the animals. Like, that's really it. The slaughterhouse videos would make me cry. And then like, as I got older, I learned more about the health aspect of veganism. I fell in love with it. Next question is from the homie Nate02. What would you be doing if you weren't the singer you are now? I'll be dead. And you guys think I'm being dramatic or kidding? I don't want to do anything else but this. Nothing else was meant for me. Next question. X.Vina.X. So what are your top 5 favorite movies? Whatever I could remember. The entire Saw series. Buffalo 66. Pulp Fiction. White Chicks. American History X. Next question. Sierra_Light says, is it hard sometimes mentally to be kind of in the spotlight 24/7? Does it get mentally draining? Definitely. I hate when I have to open up my phone and there's like a bunch of hate comments, but it's fine. You know, it's fine. Cause yakari kaka, you feel me? It is mentally draining at times, but there's definitely more positives than negatives because people have never hated on me to my face. The only thing that I hear in real life is people cheering my name, and that's all that matters. You know, that's all that I could focus on. But it does get mentally draining. And not only negative stuff, but the positive stuff too. There's people that they expect so much of you, and like, sometimes there's people that they get crazy or they get mad when I don't reply. I know it's coming from a good place because they love me, but it does get overwhelming. There's hundreds of messages, comments, everything, and it's a lot, but it's ultimately good. So there's nothing to complain about, and this is a career that I chose. Next question. Oh, another one from Vina. She says, how did you outgrow your shyness? So it's crazy because growing up, I was super shy. Like, I would never talk. Like, I would be so shy. And I always wanted to not be shy. But I just, for some reason, I could never get out of my shell until my senior year. Because I just stopped caring about everything my senior year. I was like, I'm finally going to graduate. I don't have to see these people. I don't have to come here no more. Like, I was just so excited. So I just stopped caring about literally everything. And I don't know. I don't know where it came from. I just started to be myself, and I didn't care anymore, and I stopped being shy. I started talking to random people. I would always volunteer in class. It just, I don't know. It just came naturally, I guess. Next question. Desiree060 says, why, or not why, I think she meant what. What made you so inspirational? A lot of my friends that I had growing up or in high school were not true friends. It's a constant heartbreak from people, not even relationship wise but friendship wise constantly experiencing that kind of makes you feel a little bit alone, like that you've never had someone that's been as loyal as you have, or that's giving you as much love as you've given them. And so because of that, I always felt that I lacked that one person that makes you feel like your whole world is okay. They are your world, and I wanted to be that for other people. I wanted to be the friend that I wish I always had throughout high school, throughout elementary, middle school, all that. I still want to be the person that I wish that I had and that I feel like everyone might need, because I know what it feels like to constantly be let down, broken promises, people not being able to trust people that you could. And I'll never let those experiences harden my heart. I'll always, 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 always love everybody and have a soft spot for everybody. I can't have hatred in my heart, and I can't be that way. So I would rather inspire people, just be the friend that I always wish that I had. Next question. Oh, it's also from Vina. I see she's a little bit popular today. So she goes, what's something that you regret? Something that I regret is not embracing my culture sooner. People always tell me, Jay, all of a sudden you're this. Yeah, all of a sudden I am. And what about it, foo? I'm barely 18, and it takes people some time to get educated on certain things or to mature or whatever the case may be. And that's what life is about. It's about constant evolution. I do regret not embracing my culture sooner because I feel very guilty, especially since my tata embraced it so much and I missed out on a bunch of little things that I could have done with him if I would have not been like embarrassed or, you know, like stupid stuff like that. And obviously that's definitely one of my biggest regrets ever, is just not embracing it soon enough. And that's why I make it so known, like I'm Mexican, I'm Chicana, like I make it known because I know I have a lot of young people that look up to me and I want them to embrace that. I want them to embrace their brown skin. I want them to embrace our culture, our music, our language, everything, because I regret not doing it sooner. And growing up, I always wanted to be someone else until I realized that you can't. You have to embrace what you are. Next question. Salinas Family 04 says, relationship status. I'm currently married to Eminem, obviously. So if any of you guys try to talk about him that you think he's cute or whatever, don't even try it. Don't even try because I'm just as crazy as him. Next question. Who do you like better, Eminem or X? Y'all know that you cannot ask me stuff like that. I like them equally for different reasons, okay? They're my two favorite people in the whole entire universe. Besides myself. Just kidding. My next question. Valerio1 says, what's your favorite part of performing? My favorite part is the shock on people's faces. Sometimes I could tell, like when I walk onto the stage, like people don't expect much, which is fine because I'm an upcoming artist. I expect them to not expect a lot from me. But then when I sing, I could just see the total shock on their faces. And my second favorite part of performing is the crowd afterwards. It's their cheers are, it's music to my ears, you feel me? Next question. Zuri_to_be_honest asks, how did you act when MC Magic wanted to collab with you? Let me just put a video right here.
Why don't we record a song together?
I don't know how long the video is, so I'm gonna just... Y'all can
see. What?
I won't put enough time because...
No way, you're
crazy. That's how I act. All right, next question. So Elisa_Delgado_ asks, how did you find motivation and confidence to pursue music? I want to, but I'm really shy. So get this. I used to be super shy growing up, extremely shy. I wouldn't even ask to go to the restroom during class. But being on stage, that was my second home. I was never shy to perform. That's, if anything, that's the thing I'm most confident doing, is performing. So I can't really say I ever found motivation or confidence. I always kind of just had it, like, because I always knew ever since I was little, like, I'm gonna do something bigger with my life. I can't live an average lifestyle. I don't want to. And I always known that ever since I was in elementary school. I always knew, always. And it sounds crazy, but it's true. I always knew, and nothing else was meant for me. So I just always had it in me that I just wanted to be something bigger. Next question. Elisa Delgado again. She says, Delgado. She says, who are your music influences? Definitely X. X is my biggest musical influence of all time. X is my biggest musical influence of all time. All time, all time, all time. He's number one. Next question is from Miranda879. She asks, what has inspired you to write your songs and how do you come up with your lyrics? Random things inspire me to write songs. So let me tell you, I used to want to be an author. So when I write songs, what I do is I take a small situation in my life and I over dramatize it and I turn them into a song. And lyrics, as far as lyrics, they just come to me. Not once have I ever planned when I'm gonna write a song. Every time I've written a song, it has been on accident. I never plan. I can't explain it. I can't help with the lyrics part because they always just come naturally like that. I don't know how. Okay, so it's like magic. Next question. It's from Noemi. She says, biggest struggles. Oh, I guess this is the final question. So biggest struggles, I would definitely say, are the fact that I was never taught Spanish. So because of that, a lot of people like to give me crap about it. And I am learning it. I'm not like ignorant to it and being like, oh, like I don't know Spanish. Nah, I'm trying to learn it because I want to learn it. There's a lot of benefits in being bilingual. But I do know a little bit Spanish, but I'm not fluent. So that's one thing that I get a lot of crap for, is that I don't know Spanish and people are like, they tell me stuff all the time, fake Mexican, whatever they want to say. Yakari kaka, I don't care. And another thing too is the whole Chicana thing. One struggle that definitely does come with embracing like being Chicana is that people think we're supposed to act, look, dress, just be a certain way. And it is so annoying because they forget that it's what's in your blood and the way that you live. It has nothing to do with the way that you dress or anything like that. Like, yes, Chicanos do have their own style that has a history behind it. And if you are Chicano, you're allowed to embrace that, you know? But it doesn't define you. Like, and people, if you go one day without wearing your Dickies, oh, you're a fake Chicano. Or if you do wear Dickies, oh, you're a wannabe chola. There's no way to win. it's just about what's in your blood, and like I said, the way that you live, and that's it. And people don't seem to get that. And another thing is too, my emo phase. Y'all talk about this so much. I used to have an emo phase my senior year of high school, and I did have my blue hair, and I did used to wear my crazy boots. And to be honest, I'm always thankful for my emo phase, because it got me into a lot of different types of genres, newer artists, and it expanded my expanded my creativity, and it made me more open-minded towards other genres. So that's one thing people are constantly giving me crap about, that saying I'm a fake Chicana. I don't know what that's supposed to mean, because being Chicana is in your blood, and it's a lifestyle. So okay. Another thing that I would say that is considered one of my struggles is that people like to downplay my success a lot, and I figure it's because I'm young, but they like to say without MC Magic it would be nothing and blah blah, and they're right. You know, we're a team. We're not it's not a one versus one thing. Me and him are a team. A lot of people are unaware that I made music 3 years prior to meeting MC Magic, because I met him when I was 17, and I've been making music since I was 14 years old. I was learning how to produce, write, play instruments. So it's not like he just found me and was like, sing this. Nah, we're a team. Like I said, we work together. We write together. He's my best friend. And I was talking earlier in the video that all my 18 years of living, I've never met someone who's returned my loyalty, who's returned my energy. And it's magic, you know, it's crazy, because I found that within him, even though you would never think, you know, it's like crazy. And it's great. And he's my best friend. And before anyone tries to assume anything stupid, my family is extremely involved in my career. My dad's involved, my parents. I'm friends with, you know, his kids, and I met his wife. All that. Everything's all good. But people do like to tell me stuff a lot, and I always say we're the Mexican Eminem and Dr. Dre. So, but yeah, so that's definitely a thing that people give me a lot of crap about too. Like, why did you pick her? I don't know. Ask him, foo. Yeah, he's my best friend. I appreciate him so much for everything that he's done for me. He literally owed me nothing in life, and he's helped me so much. He's the best mentor I've ever had, the best friend I've ever had. And if you're watching this, Tio Mágico, I call him that as a joke, I love you forever and ever, and I appreciate you so much. You already know that, I always tell him. but yeah, and I'm happy to be doing this with my best friend. It's dope. We're gonna be two Mexicans that take over. You already know. We don't care what you think. Well, maybe not you guys, because you guys probably like me who are watching this video, but we don't care about what no haters think, because like I said, we're gonna be at the top one day. I think that concludes this Q&A. I hope this video is not too long, because to be honest, I don't know how y'all watch me. I'm not that interesting. But I did this because you guys have been begging me to make a YouTube video, so I finally made one. I hope you like it. if you want to buy merch, you know, I got a bunch of cool stuff on my website. I got CDs. I got a whole bunch of stuff at jrocks.com. I don't know where I'm going to put it, but somewhere on the screen. jrocks.com. Also, don't forget, I am on tour right now. So I might be stopping by your city or whatever. All tour information is at lustandlovetour.com. And yeah, that concludes this Q&A. I hope this gives you a little bit more insight on who I am and whatnot. I love y'all. You already know this is my signature. And by the way, every time I go like this, it's so that you guys can complete the heart. I'm not throwing up gang signs, okay? I just love everybody, so I love hearts. You know, this just looks kind of whack. It doesn't even look like a heart. That's why I do this. But yeah. I love y'all, and until next time, bye!